COVID-19 cases in Australia soar as its system for testing buckles under the onslaught of the Omicron variant. Here's the full story.
Australia's COVID-19 cases soared to a pandemic record on Tuesday. The Omicron variant has ripped through most of the country. Hospitalizations have risen drastically, and a once formidable testing regime is buckling under lengthy wait times and stock shortages. Australia used a constant testing system for a year and a half, along with contact tracing and lockdowns to squash most outbreaks. But Tuesday's new infection numbers were up nearly a third from Monday's, which was also a record. Political leaders have pointed to a largely successful vaccination rollout and few deaths relative to new case numbers. But Prime Minister Scott Morrison's fiercest political competitor, opposition leader Anthony Albanese, says it's not good enough.
So you can't get a booster shot, even if you have an appointment. You can't get access to a PCR test because testing sites are closing and the queues go for 6 or 8 hours. You get told to get a rapid antigen test, but you can't find one. If you do find one, it's not affordable, and they won't do anything about price gouging. That's the record of this government.
Political leaders countrywide have been reshaping their messaging on COVID. After nearly 2 years of campaigning for widespread testing, authorities now ask asymptomatic people to bypass overburdened government-funded clinics and take their own rapid antigen tests. But that has brought a new pressure point, an explosion in sales of home testing kits. That's led to reports of stockpiling, empty shelves and inflated prices on the few kits which have not yet been sold. Morrison has ruled out subsidising the testing kits, citing a heightened role for personal responsibility, though the country's competition regulator plans to investigate complaints about allegations of price gouging. Despite the spike in infections fuelled by Omicron, dual-dose vaccination levels of nearly 92% in people above 16 have helped Australia to keep the death rate lower than in previous virus outbreaks. Around 2.5 million Australians have also received booster shots so far. Regardless of the soaring numbers, the number of deaths in Australia are still lower than those seen in many developed countries.
The World Health Organization sees more evidence the Omicron variant causes milder symptoms than previous COVID strains. Details in this report.
More evidence is emerging that the Omicron coronavirus variant causes milder symptoms, a World Health Organization official said on Tuesday. Evidence suggests that the variant affects the upper respiratory tract and that symptoms are less severe compared to previous variants. WHO incident manager Abdi Mahmoud explains.
We are seeing more and more studies pointing out that Omicron is infecting the upper part of the body. Unlike other ones, the lung, who has been causing severe pneumonia. It can be a good news, but we really require more studies to prove that.
Since the heavily mutated variant was first detected in November, WHO data shows it has spread quickly and emerged in at least 128 countries. But while case numbers have surged to all-time records, the hospitalization and death rates are often lower than at other phases in the pandemic.
We had a good number of studies coming up, proving again what we heard from South Africa, that the vaccine still protects you against hospitalization and severe disease and death, and that's what vaccines were designed. The challenge has not been the vaccine, but the vaccination and reaching those vulnerable populations.
However, Mahmoud also sounded a note of caution when relying on data just from South Africa, as it has a young population, among other factors. He also warned that Omicron's high transmissibility meant it would become dominant within weeks in many places, posing a threat to medical systems in countries where a high proportion of the population remains unvaccinated. Asked about whether an Omicron-specific vaccine was needed, Mahmoud said it was too early to say, but voiced doubts and stressed that the decision required global coordination.
But while the Omicron may be less severe than initially feared, a WHO official from Europe says soaring Omicron cases around the globe could increase the risk of a newer, more dangerous variant emerging. Scientists raising the alarm as deforestation in Brazil's savanna climbs to a new high last year. The details in this report.
Scientists say one of the most biodiverse areas on Earth has seen a surge in deforestation. The Cerrado savanna spreads across several states in Brazil, and on Monday, experts raised alarm over its survival. It's often called an upside-down forest because of the plant's deep roots, which sink into the ground to help survive seasonal droughts and fires. Deforestation of native vegetation rose 8% in a year ending last July, according to Brazil's National Space Research Agency. That's roughly 10 times the size of New York City. Geographer Manuel Fiera says trees in the Cerrado are disappearing with exceptional speed.
In very few places around the world have we had such a fast and intense transformation in the last 3 or 4 decades.
The savanna is also a major carbon sink, and its destruction is a major source of Brazil's greenhouse gas emissions. Amazon Environmental Research Institute director Arne Elenka points the finger at Brazil's president Jair Bolsonaro, who has called for more farming in sensitive ecosystems.
Deforestation is the most naked and raw indicator of the terrible environmental policy of this government.
The president's office did not respond to a request for comment. Bolsonaro has previously defended his policies as a means to lift the interior of the country out of poverty and says Brazil has preserved far more of its territory than Europe or the US.